Welcome back,
so
Matt Boomer.
Good to be back in the studio with an audience live.
Anyway, yeah. It's the last time you were on, you did us a favor. Thank you for coming on. It was during COVID.
It was, and
we Zoomed, and there was just us and in our homes.
Yeah.
This is a big deal. It feels great, right?
It feels so good.
Yeah. Thank you very much for coming back.
Thanks for having me.
How was everything? How's the family? How's
Everybody's
everybody?
Great. Yeah. You know, it's the holidays. Everybody's getting geared up, or I'm getting geared up. I get really excited for the holidays. I go a little overboard. The Amazon boxes just start piling up on the doorstep.
Yes, that's
but
the way to do it.
I was proud of our kids. They kind of staged an intervention this year. And they kind of said, listen, there are three things we want. Here's what they are, and then let's just get some time together. So
really?
Yeah.
That's what people dream
for
of.
For teenagers? Like,
wow, shout out to those. That's fantastic. I love that. Your name came up the other day because we had Brad Paisley on the show, and we got talking about something, and then we ended up talking about Taylor Swift at one point. Yeah. And he said that she opened for him, you know, when she first started.
Yeah.
And then he said that you came on the tour bus or something.
I did. You toured with him. I didn't tour with him. I wish I'd toured with him.
But
I did spend some time on his tour bus, and I went to his concert, and she opened for him. And it was her first album. She was just starting out, but she was this teenager performing in front of these massive stadiums. And after every song, she'd be like, oh, my gosh, I can't believe you like my music. And so...
What was she... I mean, did she talk to her backstage, and did you...
Yeah, and she was at every fan signing, and she just had that confidence that you knew she was going to be a megastar.
I love hearing those stories. Yeah. We've had her on, you know, when she... The beginning of her career, too, but it's like...
Yeah.
I love hearing the stories from real deal. You're like, dude, I was there.
I mean, to do that as a teenager...
How did you end up on the tour bus, though? I don't...
I was actually... I'm friends with Bradley's brother-in-law.
Ah.
So, yeah.
You're like, dude, I'm just going to hop on the bus.
Yeah. One night on the bus was plenty on a tour bus.
That's all you really need, yeah.
Yeah.
The other thing I wanted to bring up with you, you made headlines this summer, which I think is very fun, for a movie that you were not in.
Yeah.
Not many people do that. I mean, normally they're in the movie. We're going to talk about your movies that you're in tonight, but you could have been in Barbie.
Yes.
As one of the Kens.
Yeah.
And then it just, life said, it just, you went another way. But you auditioned for it?
I did. Yeah, I got really into it, actually. I had some projects in development, and I wasn't sure if they were going to happen or when they were going to happen, so I auditioned. And I mean, I dressed up like Malibu Ken. I dressed up like business suit Ken.
Yes.
I had like four different looks going on. I have pictures of this. Somewhere.
You went like method.
I did.
You went method acting Ken.
Yeah, I got into it.
Yeah.
And I was talking with Greta. I was looking forward to doing it. And then the things in development came to fruition. And I would have been away from my family for a year, which was just too much time away.
So. Wow. So you said, well, I'm sorry, I can't do Barbie. Now that it's the biggest movie in the world, you're like, should have done it? Or no?
No. I mean, I hope I get to work with Greta someday. She's phenomenal. But I think they made a perfect movie. And it was cast perfectly.
Yeah,
and
I think so,
I got
too.
To do Fellow Travelers and Maestro and spend time with my family.
Let's talk about the Fellow Travelers. Well, I want to get into everything. Fellow Travelers we'll get into, but Maestro.
Yeah.
This is unbelievable, by the way. Bradley Cooper, you have to watch this movie. It's just insane. How was Bradley as a director?
Oh, my gosh. I hope every actor gets to work with Bradley. He's such a generous and inspiring collaborator and scene partner. And
he crushed it in this movie.
He's unbelievable in this movie. And he's also directing at the same time. It was one of the most incredible things I've ever seen, that someone to be objective as a director and also subjective as an artist and an actor.
It's a beautiful shot. Everyone acting in it is great. And I know Spielberg produced it?
He did, yeah.
Did he come on set?
He did. He was on set a couple of days.
That would make me nervous. I mean, Bradley would make me nervous. But
I mean,
Steven Spielberg would make
E.T. is the first movie I remember seeing in a theater. I wanted to be Elliot. And to then, you know,
me too.
Fast forward.
I want to be friends with E.T. Totally.
Me too, yeah. Fast forward years, and all of a sudden we're on a set together. And, you know, he grabs the EPK camera and starts filming me during our first rehearsal with Bradley on a scene.
You're like, that counts? That counts?
Not to, like, explode.
Direct me. Tell me what to do.
Paying attention to Bradley. It was a pretty wild experience.
That's awesome. Yeah. You're great in the film. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Let's talk about Fellow Travelers. Do you read your reviews, by the way?
Not on a job like this. This is one of those jobs. I think I did 96 out of 100 days on this shoot, and I felt like I left everything on the table. So I didn't want to cloud that, you know, for good or bad with reviews.
You're like, this is the best. I'm gonna give you the best. Well, let me just read you a couple so you can plug your ears. AV Club says Matt Bomer and Jonathan Bailey delivered the best performances of their respective careers. The New Yorker says it's one of the year's best dramas.
Wow. New Yorker.
Another review says, it's not every day you watch something that makes you remember that television can be more than just good. Sometimes it can be excellent. Matt Bomer! Tell us what fellow travelers... I get excited. Come on, that's great. That's great reviews. That's tell us what that's fellow travelers is about. How do we set it up?
It's kind of like a gay the way we were. It's the gay we were.
The gay we were?
It's a multi-decade it's romance so set against a political backdrop. You follow these characters from the 50s at the height of the Lavender Scare in Washington, D.C., so it's got political intrigue as well,
yes.
All the way through the 80s in San Francisco.
It's phenomenal. I want to show a clip. Here's Matt Bomer in this Friday's episode of Fellow Travelers. Take a look at this.
Your wife said she doesn't know where you are.
Talk to Lucy.
Skippy, I need you.
Did you talk
what
to
you want
my
is my
wife?
Signature on a piece of paper to protect your secrets. And you plan to keep on lying about yourself even when you're dead. And when are we going to talk about Jackson?
No, you don't. You don't. Do you want to know what I see in Craig? He doesn't judge me.
I don't.
You are nothing but judgment. You always were. St. Tim the f***ing holy.
Woo! Come on, bud! Matt Bomer, everybody, fellow travelers, is now on Paramount Plus with Showtime. Hey, hey.